Morning everyone, today's video is about the Venn diagram. This is the second video in the same series, Venn diagram. Okay, now we have to do two things in this video. We are going to represent the complementary sets and difference of two sets using the Venn diagrams. Okay, so let's start with the one that is A complement. So complementary sets, how we represent? For example, this is our universal set which is representing by this rectangle, okay, and A is a set under this universal set, like A is a subset, proper subset of U. Now here this is A. So what is A complement? Just leave this set, whatever is left in U, that will be considered as A dash or complementary set. Okay, so this red region is representing the A complement. Next comes A minus B, difference of two sets, A minus B or B minus A. Suppose you have two sets which have few elements in common. The few elements in common are represented by this area. These are the elements which are common in A and B. If I have to find out A minus B, that means first you consider the whole A, which is this black circle, and excluding the common part. So excluding the common part, we will be left with this region. So this is known as A minus B. Similarly, B minus A, consider this full B and excluding the elements of common between A and B. So this is a region left. So this is B minus A. So how we can represent A minus B? A minus B is actually, it is equal to A minus A intersection B. And similarly, B minus A is equivalent to B minus B intersection A. Okay, next comes complementary set. How we can find out it? So U is a universal set given as the elements from 1 to 9. A is having elements 1 and 2. So A complement will be the elements which are not in A. So those will be 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. Next is, you have two sets A and B, and universal set is also given. Here the universal set is having elements from 1 to 30. So this is U with 30 elements. A is having the elements like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and B is also having some elements in common. This is A, this is B. So what are the common elements? See, whenever we draw the Venn diagram, we first just see by looking at the question that if there is something common, so we draw this kind of diagram like two intersecting circles and start filling out with the common part first. So here, what are the elements which are common? So 2 and then 5. So we will write here 2 and 5, or I can write like, okay, A intersection B, how many elements are there? How many elements is like N? Okay, so always whenever you have given two sets like A and B or three sets, we always start filling out first the common regions. Okay, I will explain in my next videos also. I want to make this video very simple. Okay, this whole topic very simple. So that's why I'm discussing like two things in one video, not more than that. And after completing all these Venn diagram basic videos, we will directly go to the questions. And once you will watch those videos with questions, I'm sure that Venn diagram will no more be difficult for you people. Okay. So here I am filling these two elements which are common. Then what is A? It is 1, 3, 4, 6. So 1, 3, 4, 6. And in B we have 9, 8, 10. Now this part, A minus B, we can consider it like A only also. Only A. There is no other element. In the questions, you will read this kind of words. A only or A minus B. They are having same meaning. So A only means the elements which are not common with A. Those elements we cannot take. So like here 2 and 5 are common elements. We will not take them. So A minus B will be just 4 elements. 1, 3, 4, 6, this region. And if I am saying B minus A, B minus A will have the elements 9, 8 and 10. Remove all the other elements if AB is in common with some other set. Okay. So this is your B minus A. I hope this video is clear to you. Please don't consider that these are very simple ideas. These ideas are the basic building blocks of the upcoming videos. Okay. I hope this video is clear to you. Thank you.